The problem of RBI is, as a monetary management authority, monetary policy authority, is to maintain sufficient amount of liquidity in the system. If it is excess, bring that out. Like you require water, it's too much water, drain it out. If there is a shortage of water, bring in water, so there is no shortage. Now, with respect to liquidity, that is availability of credit, etcetera, in the system, it has to provide a mechanism to inject funds and withdraw funds, but with the opening up of the economy, system is getting very complex. Now, you have the export market opened, so a lot of funds coming in also. Now, for the export market to develop in the initial years, a lot of funds are required for the exporters. Then you have said you have a free market economy, industry can develop. So, the firms need to borrow money. So, funds need to be available for them at, you know, proper rate, etcetera. Now, this part is the discretionary liquidity, because the autonomous liquidity is something which is autonomous. I mean, it just has its own life. The amount of money that the rainfall, for instance, if you take the example of rainfall, monsoon provides a rainfall which you cannot control. Now, if rainfall is sufficient, it's good news. If rainfall is insufficient, you need to arrange for irrigation facilities. If rainfall is too much, which you have seen this year in some areas like Assam, then you have another kind of problem. Now, autonomous liquidity is like monsoon. Now, the discretionary part is within the control of the RBI, what it should do. Now, ILF is a system they initiated for 1 year in April 1999 with four kinds of instruments in the basket. One is the repo rates. They said these are market determined repo rates. Actually, what is happening is they are not market determined. The language is confusing. The repos are determined by RBI, the repo rates determined by RBI, just now what it also does, it announces repo and reverse repo rate, but that determination process takes into consideration the market situation. I determine it. Suppose I see in the market some kind of policies I need to maintain because of certain situations. Say I need a tight monetary policy. So, they would immediately raise the repo rates and the reverse repo rates. Now, you require relaxed policy, they would lower the repo rates. That means basically what it is saying, banks, you can borrow money from us at a lower interest rate. Repo rate is what? Lower interest rate. Or when I take out money from you, I give a lower rate. All right? Now, this kind of a market determined repo rate, which is a language that confused me initially, but I understood what it is. The RBI determines it, but it takes into consideration the factors in the market, present in the market. All right? Okay. Now, repo is all right. Then they had ECRF. I mentioned that ECRF. ECRF is export credit. You can imagine export, if you remember the last course you took, the reforms had an emphasis on a few areas, industrial licensing policies. Then they had emphasis on the trade sector liberalization. Then they had emphasis on MRTP. If you remember four or five items I listed when the reform, structural reforms I taught you in the previous course. So, exports have become very important now. Now, this export credit refinance, meaning what? Banks, if they are unwilling to give funds, which they have always done even with respect to rural credit, banks unwilling, okay, I am giving you the money, banks, now you distribute the money or disburse them, all right, at rates I tell you. Say for farmers, if banks go or go about doing the business on its profit, on the basis of its profit motive, it will not give money, it will give very little money, credit. And also, it will charge an interest rate which is not affordable. Now, if you have to do kind of a social banking, help out the farmers, then the banks have to be told, okay, okay, give money, I will reimburse them or I will refinance them. Particularly in the case of default, because you are giving to poor borrowers who may not return the money. So, banks often are reluctant. Now, the export market is just picking up. Now, you have to develop the competitiveness in the international market, not domestic. Domestic mein to aap hai ho sakte 10 saal 20 saal 25 saal one kind of game, but now you are going into the international market where you are competing with, imagine the competitors, if they particularly if they come from the first world, even China is a very big competitor. So the export market is also a very uncertain place where banks would be kind of reluctant to invest initially, at least. And imagine, I'm talking about 10, 15 years back, 13 years back story. So what they did was, this RBI would export credit refinance facility they provided. I will tell you a little bit about export credit refinance facility if I have it anywhere. No, I don't have it yet. Now, but it's understood what it is, and the whole thing of open market operation is still there. But the funny thing about open market operations in India, you didn't come to me with that question. I think I was thinking about you, maybe Antaragni after that. Borrowed, unborrowed reserves. I got stuck because I touched upon that many years back. I may have still in my notes a little bit, but not much. Okay. Now, the open market operations are what? It's controlling money supply. It's a traditional monetary policy instrument. You will see in your notes, I've taught you. But the problem is that the open market operations in India are very peculiar. When it went for open market purchase, it went to the market, open market purchase when they're injecting funds. And when they went for open market sale, I will show you the data, it's coming up in this topic, it's primarily state governments. Open market operations are two types, purchase and sale. In case of purchase, they are gone from the market interactions. So, banks, non-banks, everybody were there, public. Open market sale, when the funds are coming out of the system into RBI's pocket, sale of securities, because when you are selling security, you are getting cash back. So, money is drained out of the system, contractionary policy. That was primarily with reference to state governments. So, state governments were like using that as an investment opportunity. It's not open market operation as a monetary policy. State government, if they are surplus funds, the best way to put the money in is government documents, dated securities, because central government securities. So, state governments investing the surplus funds primarily in central government dated securities. So, it's no open market operation in that sense, very effective, the way it is used in other countries, where these are traditional instruments. So, in India, the monetary policy instruments which are most effective seems to be the repo rates and the CRR, seems to be, not bank rate, not open market operations. So, open market operations, it seems to be, it's there in the basket, not to the market, just not always the state government. So, it's giving only the opportunity to state governments to invest the surplus funds. If you look at the data, these things become clear when you look at the data. The actual working of the system, how it works. Alright. If you don't understand, we will have a discussion class on this before I start a new topic. Now, and a collateralized lending facility, I have a huge amount of note here. I will pass on these notes to you. Let me tell you what it did. Collateralized means what? Banks can borrow against securities. Collateral is security. I want to borrow funds from a bank loan. I show my property, my wife, a flat, a land, whatever I have. Collateral is lending. Banks usually have. Okay? So I do a collateral borrowing. Now, CLF, collateral lending facility, was available. Let me read out a few things just to have an impression in your mind. It will create an impression on your mind. You don't have to memorize these things. I remember not really. You look at my questions very, some of it is a little bit more probably, but most are not memorizing stuff. CLF was available up to 25%, 25% of the fortnightly, 25% of the fortnightly average outstanding aggregate deposits of banks in 1997-98. So 97-98 may whatever the outstanding aggregate deposits bank had, they would give a CLF to the amount of 25% of the fortnightly average.
of that year for a duration of 2 weeks. No, not 20%, I'm very sorry. Not 25%, 0.25%. 25% pay, 0.25%, less than 1%. 1/4 of a percentage point of that aggregate deposits, they will give you as a collateralized lending facility at the bank rate, with interest. And central bank lends, I was telling you, bank rate is often the yardstick, the interest rate. So it has been given 1/4 of a percentage point of your aggregate deposits, 97, 98, 490 averages, all right, would be given to a bank for a duration of 2 weeks. Extra funding from RBI to fund whatever. An additional CLF, which is called ACLF, additional collateralized lending facility, of an equivalent amount was also made available to the bank at the bank rate plus 2%. Additional, you can also get an equivalent amount, that means 1/4 of the 1/4 of a percentage point of aggregate deposits, where aggregate deposits referred to 1997-98 financial year, can be given again to you, but the interest rate will be bank rate plus 2% more, because this is an additional fee to banks lending. I'm reading out, I'll give you the note, so you don't have to memorize, you just have to listen to it. An ACLF average beyond 2 weeks would be subject to a penal rate of 2% for an additional 2 weeks. So if you avail ACLF beyond 2 weeks, then there will be a penalty rate of 2%. So they are available for 2 weeks, 2 weeks. First, CLF for 2 weeks. 1/4 of a percentage point of your aggregate deposits. Given to you at a bank rate for 2 weeks. Not a very short-term lending. Money market lending. By RBI to the banks. Now, you need more cash because there's a lot of export finance or whatever going on. Industrial finance. Or you're short of money. You've given out too much loan. Too much demand for loans maybe. So increasing the liquidity. Okay, 2 more weeks, we will give you the same amount, but the interest rate will be bank rate plus 2%. You want 2 more weeks, that to be extended again, ACLF, then it will be a penalty of 2x, 2 rate. Probably it's not if you don't return the money, but it is written for an additional 2 weeks. There will be an extra penalty of 2% again. Now, ECRF, Export Credit Refinance Facility, which is coming to what I was trying to teach you, that whenever RBI lends, the bank rate is the measuring rate. So that is also at bank rate, given to the banks, export credit. All right, CLF, bank rate initially, additional CLF, 2% plus bank rate. Then, this money, liquidity support against collateral government securities, what RBI did, this is what I have to teach you, this is the modern Indian era now, after 1990s. RBI is creating satellites. So I'm the sun sitting here, but I've created satellite stars. You interact with them. You don't have to even come to me. They're called primary dealers. I'm coming to that. PDs. The famous primary dealer in India is Discount and Finance House of India, DFHI. All right. So this funding banks could access not without even coming to RBI. They don't have to. RBI is kind of decentralizing its functions. NABARD was the first case to decentralize. Now these days they also do. So they created private dealers and you go to private dealers and take the funds from them. And RBI makes them available with private. And private dealers, when it does a lending, very interesting, it gives money for these purposes to private dealers, who would give the CLF, SCLF to banks. Private dealers, they have made them not kind of passive organizations. Private dealers, they said, okay, you make money, but money earned by lending, all right, SCLF, whatever. But when you borrow money, when I give you money, although you are my satellite organization, you will have to pay an interest to me, very interest. All right? So you will become conscious when you lend, so that you have to earn and you have to lend efficiently. Private dealers are like father asking the son, okay, if you borrow money from me, all right, you look after it, but you will have to give me this return. It's not costless. So when you spend the money, you have to be careful when you give the money to anybody. So private dealers were also asked to pay something, right? From interest rate. And you have seen repo and open market. They found, based on the experience of ILF for a period of 1 year, an internal group of the RBI, they always had this, an internal group of the consisting of, you know, the governors and the deputy governors or whatever, sometimes the governor himself, RBI governor and the deputy governors and board of the directors, they form groups called working groups. The internal group of RBI recommended phased implementation of full-fledged liquidity adjustment facility, but it's very interesting how it came about later. It came into existence in June 2000. LAF came, which is still there. If you open RBI, you get the repo, reverse repo data. Top, it is written under LAF scheme. Here it is. This June 2000, It came, this is this LAF, Liquidity Adjustment Facility of the RBI. It was recommended by RBI's internal group, and you won't believe me, LAF operates only through repo and reverse repo auctions of all transferable government debt securities. All that extra stuff gone.